We've been looking at all the ways support can play a role in helping out new mothers after they give birth. That can be especially true when moms realize they need some extra help medically. For Jessica Katz, that realization came a little more than 6 weeks after her daughter Marion's birth.
It was almost as if like things just weren't in the right place. I just felt really uncomfortable. I found a few forums online, and the way people described it, which I agree with, is it feels like a tampon is not fully inserted all the time.
Jessica's discomfort made it hard for her to go about her day-to-day life.
I missed being able to go running without fearing that my body was gonna like fall apart. And the stress of just being a new mom, mix that with feeling really uncomfortable, unattractive, and like you're broken and you're never gonna get better.
Jessica went back to her doctor, who told her to see if time would help her body heal.
Maybe a couple months and come back in for another checkup. So I gave it some time and it didn't get any better.
She was then referred to Dr. Cynthia Brincat and diagnosed with the bladder prolapse.
Bladder prolapse is when the top wall of the vagina is relaxed and then the bladder comes down a little bit in the vagina. We know that a big contributor to prolapse is damage to the muscles. There's nothing the mom did, there's nothing the baby did, and a lot of the times there's not a lot we can do to prevent it.
While doctors can't predict why it happens, they do know there are a number of factors that can make a woman more prone to muscle damage during birth.
We know that women who have a forceps-assisted vaginal delivery, those women are more prone to have a muscle tear. We know that women with bigger babies are more prone to have a muscle tear. We know very quick births and very long births are prone to have a muscle tear.
Dr. Brincat helped Jessica better understand what a bladder prolapse is.
She was able to give me so much information, and more than anything, she gave me the reassurance that things will get better.
We want to make sure that we meet the problem head on. A vast number of our patients feel better just with conservative measures.
To be told it's going to be okay, that was huge.
The doctor had Jessica start pelvic floor physical therapy.
She was doing about one session a week, and after about 10 sessions, she noted some significant improvement. These are special physical therapists, predominantly women, that are trained to help rehabilitate and heal the pelvic floor muscles.
The physical therapy has been huge. I still go and I'm still improving. I don't feel uncomfortable when I go for several mile walks with my daughter anymore, which is awesome.
Jessica was also given a pessary.
You can think about a pessary as like a bra for the vagina. If things are falling down, a pessary can go in, hold things up and take the pressure off the muscles. And sometimes that can allow the muscles to heal a little bit better.
I fall back on it when I feel like weak some days and I'm just a little uncomfortable, but I don't use it as often.
With both of those treatments, Jessica has begun to feel a lot better.
Physically, I know I've gotten stronger, so that's great. And I look forward to getting even stronger.
She's doing really well. So her symptoms aren't perfect, but they're significantly better.
I feel a million times better.
Dr. Brincat says seeking help is key.
I think that is the take home. You're not stuck with this. There is help out there, and by talking about it with your providers, that's the way to get that kind of help.
Talking to people and then also using the resources that are out there, I think, is important to getting better. For me, it was great to have a really supportive husband who's constantly trying to remind me to stay positive.
It isn't anything to be ashamed about. You can then make the decision what kind of treatment would be best for you after being informed. Knowledge is power.
Jessica says now that she's feeling better, she can focus on quality time with Marion.
I think that it's really hard to give your child your best side if you aren't healthy. And so I'm so happy that I'm working on this part of my life and I've come so far.
If you're feeling something in those immediate postpartum stages, it's okay to talk to your doctor about it. And there are plenty of conservative measures and appropriate treatments that we can do that will allow you to have a significant improvement.
Not being afraid to talk about the issues, I think, a big thing. So I recommend not isolating yourself. Get that support that they need